invited to a new show in the Fireside Room here at the Samarkand by two artists, Anne Pedersen and Barbara Larson, both friends. The work on display, it's mostly watercolor, painted either on location or from photo reference. Some of the work is abstract, all pretty much painted, I'm told, within the last 6 years or so. Painting is clearly their passion, and they continue to paint while finding inspiration from their beautiful surroundings. So this is just wonderful to sit with both of you. I know you're good friends, and I'm wondering, do you actually paint together?
We have.
You know, we did that a couple of times. We sat together, I remember, over by the Westview in the garden area over there, and I recall that, and I think we have gone.
We went to Alice Keck Memorial Park.
Okay.
Because you're both plein air painters.
Alice Keck. Mm-hmm.
Ask you, what keeps you painting? What keeps you thinking about, I'm going to get up and paint today? This is after many years of your own painting. Yeah. Here you are, almost 90 years old. Yeah. What drives you to do your artwork?
We live in a beautiful place.
Yeah,
we live in a beautiful neighborhood. Mm-hmm. I adore the various neighborhoods that we walk through. And I take pictures, and those are my inspiration. I take pictures, and I do, I use them as subjects, but I can't stand there and paint them anymore. I've done that plein air painting a few times, but that's gone for me now. So, but I feel that nothing should be forgotten about my watercolor painting. If I keep on doing it, I will do better. I know that. I feel that. Mm-hmm. And I think I can keep on doing this as long as possible. And I'm finally reading and learning about women who are really older, who start painting well into their 60s and 70s, and then they keep on doing it. And that's lovely. I love that idea.
How about you, Barbara? What keeps you painting?
What keeps me painting?
I know that you just saw the show up in San Francisco, Joan Mitchell's, and yeah, you sounded so excited by that. What?
I did. Joan Mitchell is a abstract expressionist painter from the last half of the last century, and I've admired her work for a while. So that's inspired me. For several years, I've had an interest in merging landscape and abstract. And so I've taken classes in both, but it's really going to be up to me to pull them together. So this is something I want to try to do.
That's a great challenge. It's my challenge too.
Thank you. Yeah. I mentioned taking classes, and I do find that keeps me going. And also during the lockdown for the last couple of years, this has been on Zoom. And I like that because you can be in your own studio. You don't have to lug stuff anywhere, and you just kind of join the group, you know, there on your computer.
Yeah.
When Anne was talking about older women who paint, it's always fascinated me that so many artists, I mean, visual artists, also musicians, keep doing their practice until they're, you know, well into their 90s. It seems like maybe it keeps you alive and younger. So I think it's a healthy thing to do too. Mm-hmm. So the painting over in the corner, the native plant garden, it's the far corner, far on the left, mm-hmm. Was really fun for me. It was the result of going to that garden a number of times when the wildflowers were in bloom, and really enjoying the colors there and the whole kind of bursting with spring atmosphere.
Is it the floral piece or the landscape?
The landscape.
The landscape.
The one that's on the far, the one that's sold.
Okay.
That's
pretty good. Yeah.
I think that person likes that location too. And that's,
captured it beautifully. You did.
And I did a number of small watercolor sketches. Sometimes they look very abstract, in fact, you know, just of all the colors.
Mm-hmm. What is there a piece that you feel most, just closest to?
This one in the center is Los Canetos Lake. And Dad and I have walked around that lake any number of times, and we have enjoyed it. And I have taken, probably done about two or three of those paintings. This is the best one I did. And then it wasn't until probably about a month ago, before we put the show up, I thought I wanted a little bit different shadow under the hedge on either side, and I moistened the whole page, or the lake. I moistened the whole lake there, and then dropped the shadow down, and that made a huge difference in the painting.
That shadow in the lake.
And it turned out
beautiful.
Yeah. I think it turned out well.
Yeah.
And then the clouds I could leave alone. Hi, Harlan.
Hi.
Oh, I heard the door open.
Yours was doing good too.
Hi, Dad. You can take your mask off and take a seat if you want.
We had on Orcas Island, and I remember painting that picture. That was one of the pictures here that I painted before we moved into the Samarkand. And I was really, really kind of sad to have to move out of that house. I loved that house. Mm-hmm. And my husband designed that house.
The West Sound, Dad, we were just talking about that house today. The West Sound House. There's the architect, Harlan Pedersen. If you could tell your younger self as an artist, because you've done art, both of you have done mm-hmm. art your whole lives, mm-hmm. what would you tell yourself? Here you are at where you are in your life with all the experience, or maybe just life experience. What would you tell your younger self?
Well, our younger self might have said, I love being in this place, but I always want to go to the beach. Or something, there's something in your life where you're happy to be in that atmosphere. And so mm-hmm. I think that we have that feeling. We get more intensive about how something feels. Mm-hmm. What about the beautiful mountains mm-hmm. that we have to look at? And we stop talking sometimes together, looking at the mountains and say, look at that beautiful way. Look at the shadows. Mm-hmm. You're looking at all these things that you're thinking, I could do that. I would love to paint that.
Mm-hmm.
And you begin to look at scenes and just doing a walk or sitting down and enjoying just the sort of the shade that you're sitting in,
mm-hmm.
and you you want to paint it.
Yeah.
You want to paint that very thing.
Yeah.
And I felt that my father was one of those people that he had to go and paint the poppies.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. He loved to go out and see certain places where he was moved to be wanting to go to. So I think I might have inherited some of that.
Mm-hmm. Who knows? I think I might have inherited some of that too.
I think so.
We always want to paint. It is, and every day I feel like I want to paint every single day. Mm-hmm. Thank you for that, Jean.
Mm-hmm.
So, Barbara, I'll ask you the same question. What would you tell your younger self today if you could see her sitting there with her paintbrush in hand? Is there anything that you could just yell back or forward in time?
I would say trust yourself. Believe in yourself. People will doubt you, but let that go. And keep on doing what you love. That's it.
That's good. So, Dad?
Yeah?
Let me ask you.
Yeah?
What has art meant in your life?
A lot in my life. Being an architect, I've obviously... in that quite a bit. Up until just about 2-3 months ago, then that was the end of it.
Because of your eyes?
Because of my eyes.
Mm-hmm. Do you think about art?
I did then a lot, all the way through. Being an architect, that would keep me busy for almost at the end of the war until now. I mean, until 3 months ago.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And how about your family or your wife who keeps pursuing her artwork?
Okay.
What does that mean to
she's
you?
She's the most dearest woman in the world.
Yes.
What?
Yeah.
He's going to go now.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. See you, Harlan.
Bye, Dad.
Bye.
Then field painting, I never could understand very well. Frankenthaler, I understood that, you know, it was, and I suppose Sam Francis, but I suppose you'd put Joan Mitchell in that category too. I don't know.